More now from that revealing New York Times interview. In one of the tidbits, President Trump says the media will help him win another term. He says, quote, another reason that we're going to win another 4 years is because newspapers, television, all forms of media will tank if I'm not there, because without me, their ratings are going down the tubes. Without me, the New York Times will indeed be not the failing New York Times, but the failed New York Times. So they basically have to let me win. And eventually, probably 6 months before the election, they'll be loving me because they're saying, please, please don't lose Donald Trump, okay? Joining us now, CNN White House correspondent Abby Phillip and Bill Carter, CNN media analyst. Great to see you guys. Okay, so Bill, he has a point.
He does have a point
that the ratings have gone up, and there has certainly been a lot more interest in journalism during the era of Donald Trump, fact-checking, going back to primary sources, getting the facts. That has gone up. He's right about that. I like that he thinks that the media controls who wins and that we can let him win.
Yes,
I think that's a lot
true.
Of power that
and
he's
that,
giving
And
us.
That we won't do our jobs.
That's
we
right.
will sell out for money.
Of course.
Because that's what he would do.
He's focused on ratings.
He must be. That's right. Exactly. And I do think that he's right in this sense. Whenever he leaves office, the television ratings probably will go down because people do watch in a very unnerved way now because they don't know what he's so unpredictable and things are so, you know, controversial under him that people are compelled to watch more than they would be with almost anyone else in office, I think.
Abby, as someone who's familiar, a reporter's familiar with the communication shop within the White House there, and the fact everybody's been clamoring for interviews with the president, everybody would love to see a year-end press conference. Talk about your impressions of him just impromptu sitting down at the country club grill after a round of golf with a couple New York Times guys and no minders around him.
It's incredibly Trumpian, really. I mean, I think this is the kind of thing that Trump has been known to do. On numerous occasions in the last year, he's picked up the phone and just called a New York Times reporter, a Washington Post reporter, and I think this is important to know about him too, that he really values the opinion of the New York Times. That is his hometown paper. He despite the criticism, the failing New York Times, he likes being in the New York Times, being on the front page. And I think his comments about the media and the election reflect that too. It's a little bit tongue-in-cheek, to be fair. I think the president is just trying to kind of mess around with us here. But on some level, it reflects the idea that the president always likes being at the front of people's minds. He likes being on the front page, on cable news every single morning. And that is what drives a lot of his behavior day to day. So the idea, you know, the fact that the president would have been golfing earlier in the morning, runs into a New York Times reporter at his property and just decides to sit down and chat is really what Trump does. I mean, he often does these things without many of his aides or his communications shop really having any idea about what is going on.
You know, one of the revealing things I thought was that it reveals he wants another 4 years, okay?
Yes.
So we had heard from some places, some corners, like Steve Bannon, who gave him like a 30% chance of finishing out his first term. But here he says that he will win the next 4 years. He wants the next 4 years. I mean, I think that, look, this is a window into what his thinking is right now, particularly since he doesn't have minders. And so that was the first time that I had heard him say that he's gunning for 8 years.
Well,
you know?
Of course, but once he was in, who thought he would give up this attention?
Steve Bannon.
He loves attention.
Steve Bannon.
Steve Bannon doesn't know him then. If you know Donald, you know he doesn't want to ever have anything but maximum attention. And what could be bigger than being president? So he's not going to give that up willingly. So.